everyone, welcome to Magic TV. I'm Tristan Shaun Gregson, and you'll realize that Luis Scott-Vargas has been replaced this week with a sheet of paper. That's because he's phoning it in, or this time, really, he emailed it in. Because they're all down in San Diego. We're talking Conley Woods, we're talking Brad Nelson, we're talking Brian Kibler, we're talking Gabe Walls, testing for Paris. Meanwhile, I'm here with a list of cards they like out of Mirrodin Besieged. So, we've got a few people that were nice enough to email me some lists of their top 8 cards for not only standard, but also limited. So this time around, we're going to start right with Conley Woods and talk about his top 8 cards for Mirrodin Besieged. Starting with limited, we have Flesh Eater Imp. Now, I mean, I've said it before, we can say it again. This guy is a blowout. If you don't look at him, you don't look at him and you don't control him soon, he's just going to blow you out. From there, we got Thopter Assembly, which, again, like, it just makes infinite blockers. I mean, how can you get through this guy? It's amazing. And then you can Alpha Strike with him. You've got Tezzeret, Agent of Bolas. Now, this is kind of a speculative thing. Like, how good is this guy going to be in Limited? Apparently, everybody thinks there's enough artifacts out there. He's going to get the job done. Then it's a Zenith party. We've got Red Sun Zenith. Everybody knows Fireball, or Disintegrate, I guess, in this case. Now you can get it back. And then we all know Mutilate or Infest. We've got Black Sun Zenith from him in the number 4 spot. You know, we all get it. It's Wrath of God. It's really good. Coming in for number 3, we have another Wrath of God effect. We have Phyrexian Rebirth. You even get a token out of it. It's a lot better in Limited than it is in Standard because there's no Jace to bounce your big token after it's all said and done. In number 2, Connolly's got Consecrated Sphinx, which is a bit of a surprise to me because it just seems like a big flying guy, but apparently a big flyer who also nets you a whole bunch of cards is just what you're looking for in Limited. And last but not least, we've got Massacre Worm, who appears to be a massacre in Limited. He just blows everybody out and, you know, comes down, wrecks the board. Moving on to Connolly's top 8 cards from Standard, number 8 is Contested Warzone. A bit of a surprise to me as well. Connolly isn't usually known for attacking, but he is known for playing with kind of obscure off-the-wall cards, and Contested Warzone is obviously one of those ones that isn't too straightforward to play with in Constructed, but he's a big fan. Number 7, we've got Thrawn, the Last Troll. Seems like it's going to be on everybody's list, coming in number 7 this time. Number 6, we've got Bone Horde. A big fan of this card. Obviously, it's making Stoneforge Mystic even better right now as you can tutor for a creature, and it's the most efficiently accosted living weapon. And number 5, we've got Ink Moth Nexus. A bit of surprise it's going to be on the list right now, considering there aren't that many Infect guys for Constructed, but maybe being able to hit your opponent for, you know, 10% of their life total and having that kind of evasion is going to be good enough in the current Standard. Number 4, we've got Sphere of the Suns. Not at all a surprise from Conley Woods. Look at this card. It's mana acceleration. It's an artifact. It's going to go a long distance, I think, in the future. Hopefully you can find a home for it right now. Which leads right in number 3 for Constructed, which is Tezzeret, Agent of Bolas again. Obviously, he makes a lot more sense in Constructed right now as opposed to Limited. I'm really looking forward to see what Conley does with this card. Number 2, we've got Green Sun Zenith. Not at all a surprise here. A lot of our writers have already talked about how much this card can do in Constructed. It's great. It's great early. It's great late. It's going to do everything. It's number 2. And last but not least, number 1 for Conley Woods in Constructed. Go for the Throat. Not a surprise. This card answers everything in the format. And then other formats as well. But for Standard, it's most important. Well, there you have it. Conley Woods' very fast look at the top 8 cards for Limited and Constructed from Mirrodin Besieged. Now, we have a special guest list this time around. Brad Nelson, who you may or may not know of, he might have been on the show a couple of times, was nice enough to send me his list of the cards he thinks are going to be great for Limited and Constructed with Mirrodin Besieged. So, right into Brad's lists. Coming in at number 8 in Limited, we've got Mortipod, which is pretty exciting once you stop and look at it, because it's the creature that still deals the damage. Thusly, if you have Infect guys, they're still going to deal your opponent poison damage, making the living weapon even more of a weapon. At number 7, he's got Tezzeret the Agent, kind of the same thing we've said before, a little bit lower than where Connolly put it, but still a force to be reckoned with in Limited. At number 6, we've got Glissa the Traitor, which, I mean, yeah, she's balmy. She's 3/3 first strike death touch. It's going to be hard to get around. Brad's also a little more interested in artifacts than other players. He's got number 5, he's got Creeping Corrosion. I mean, we all know Shatterstorm, now it's green. Let's see what it can do in Mirrodin Limited. He's also a big fan of Consecrated Sphinx, coming in at number 4. I mean, that big flyer is going to net you some cards, already get some card advantage. It's all upside from there. Number three, he's got the first White Sun Zenith on our list countdown today. Obviously, the big cat orgy is going to be great for everybody, making a whole bunch of these guys at instant speed. And of course, the card that wipes it out, he's got in the number two spot, Massacre Worm. We're all familiar with what that guy can do now. And last but not least, number one on the limited side for Brad Nelson, he's got Ink Moth Nexus. Obviously, quite the card in limited. A attacker who is defended on your opponent's turns, gets in there with the evasion. The number one card from Brad Nelson in Mirrodin Besieged Limited. Moving on to his top eight standard, he's got Tezzeret, Agent of Bolas at number eight. Not quite as high as Conley Woods, probably not trying to brew decks with it right now, but obviously going to be a force in standard to come. Number seven, he's got Phyrexian Vatmother, a card that I'm really excited to see on the standard list. Hopefully a card we're going to see a lot more action from in the future as more infect creatures are rolled out into Constructed. Number six, we've got Sword of Feast and Famine. Seems pretty obvious. More swords, more weapons, more protection, all on the up and up. On number five, he's got Go for the Throat. Obviously, the removal spell is going to be dominant in all Constructed formats right now, but it also pushes the envelope for artifact decks to come around a little bit more to get around this card. Maybe that's why Brad's got it down number five spot. Number four, he's got the Green Sun Zenith. Seems pretty obvious there. Not a whole lot more to say about that card. Number three, he's got Thrawn, the Last Troll. Valuing a little higher than these other cards we mentioned before. I think he thinks the 4-4 Shroud Troll is going to be a big deal in all this Jace-heavy metagame. Number two, we've got Hero of Bladehold. Obviously kind of that Ranger of Eos replacement for the Boros decks. Pretty excited to see what this 4-drop could do in Standard. Maybe make a new White Weenie deck. Knight decks are very popular right now. We'll see where it goes. And yet again, in the number one spot for Brad Nelson, Ink Moth Nexus. If I didn't know better, I'd say Brad was a pretty big fan of this card. Not a whole lot more he could say right there. I mean, he loves it in Limited, he loves it in Constructed. Well, there you have it. Now we're left with our own Luis Scott-Vargas' list of his top eight cards for Limited and Constructed. So in standard Luis fashion, we'll do the coming in at number eight. We've got Red Sun Zenith in Limited. Obviously a big fan of Disintegrate. He likes the card. I mean, who doesn't? It's reusable Fireball or Disintegrate, like I keep saying. Number seven, he's got Thopter Assembly as well. Again, this card is quite the force to be reckoned with. It comes down, it makes infinite blockers. Maybe it makes some evasion later in the game. It's a very solid card all the way around. Luis is also a big fan of the Black Sun Zenith. I mean, who isn't? Knowing for playing Control, the opportunity to wipe the board in Limited is always strong. Even with his number five pick, which is the White Sun Zenith. The big cat call, again, coming big for Luis. Number four, he's also a fan of Consecrated Sphinx. Who would have thought? Drawing cards, blue, a flyer, Luis. Wouldn't have guessed it. In the number three spot, again, we've got Tezzeret, Agent of Bolas. Hopefully he's kind of in the same boat with Connolly, where we want to make decks with this card and construct it. It happens to have a blue mana symbol in the casting cost. You gotta assume that means something for him. Although, again, we are talking about Limited this time around. But again, it's in the number three spot. Number two, we've got Phyrexian Rebirth. Luis, again, big fan of the Wrath effects. And the white one coming in just behind the number one card for Luis Scott-Vargas in Limited from Mirrodin Besieged, Massacre Worm. Surprise, surprise. This guy is a massacre. And that's my worst Luis pun that I can make right now. Moving on to Constructed for Luis. Again, still big fans of the Zeniths. Number eight, we've got Black Sun Zenith. Obviously, the versatility here with minus one counters on all your opponents, or on all creatures, is going to go a long way. If you can't wrath the board in one shot, you can make things smaller at least, which will obviously work to your advantage. And number seven, we have the White Sun Zenith. The cat call one more time. Luis rocking it in control decks, I'm sure, in the near future. Kind of a Decree of Justice type effect, which I know he's a huge fan of. Number six, Luis actually has Contested Warzone. Apparently, not only is Conley Woods a fan of this card, Luis thinks it's better than a couple of those sweet Zeniths we know are going to be sweet and constructed. In number five, he's got Thrawn, the Last Troll. I'm surprised he even bothered to put it on this list, considering how much he hates cards that are stop Jace or even other blue mages. Number four, we've got Ink Moth Nexus. Definitely seeing a trend here among the pros. This card is going to do something. It might not be today, it might be tomorrow. It might have already happened. These guys are working on Paris decks right now. This might be the card. Number three, again, for Constructed, as well as Limited for Luis. We've got Tezzeret, Agent of Bolas. Got to assume they're brewing a deck for this card right now. It seems that strong if all these guys are valuing it so high. Number two, go for the throat one more time. The removal spell, the new path to exile, the new board sweeper. Well, not really, but with so many one creature boards, it seems like it. For only two mana, it's getting rid of everything short of Wurmcoil Engine in this format. That's pretty impressive. And last but not least, we've got Green Sun Zenith. Luis Scott-Vargas' pick for number one card. Seems like Paolo's pick for number one card. Impressive all the way around. That was a lot, everybody. There you go. Conley Woods, Brad Nelson, Luis Scott-Vargas. They're busy actually playing Magic, so I'm just reporting the list to you. Take it all in. Take a look at it. I'm going to catch my breath here for a minute. And yeah, thanks for tuning in. Weigh in on your top eights in the comments. And until then, for me and Humphrey, thanks for watching.